Right, I'm here to do my UFC on FX7 predictions video. You'll have to excuse the fact that this is going to be quite a quick one, and that's mainly because of my voice. It's not a numbered event, so I shall only be picking a few fights that I'm sort of interested in. Gabriel Gonzaga is fighting Ben Rothwell. Now, Ben Rothwell has a stupid record, 32-8. Gabriel Gonzaga, 13-6, and he's sort of best known, I suppose, in his career for the for basically starting the decline of poor Krokop. Now, I happen to have been live at that event and actually saw that. I rather hope that Gabriel Gonzaga is going to win. I think this is quite a close one to call. I think that this is going to be a stand-up match between them both. I hope that Gabriel Gonzaga can win. But I'm going to go for a TKO in the third, and I wouldn't be surprised, actually, if the if that prediction's reversed. Thiago Tavares is fighting Khabib Nurmagomedov. He's one to watch because he's done very well since entering into the UFC, winning twice. He's still got a perfect record. It's now 8. He's mainly a ground fighter, which is okay because so is Thiago Tavares, who is 17-4. You know, again, I think this is actually closer than a lot of people would think. I'm going to go for Thiago Tavares on this one with some sort of bar submission or possibly a decision if that's not applicable. But I do think that you know, if Khabib wins this one, then he's actually gone somewhere, and I think there'll be a lot of notice in him. I think this could well be fight of the night next. This is Diego Nunes and Nick Lentz. Now, Diego Nunes is the king of decisions, be it winning or losing by. His record, I don't quite know because I sort of copied it down wrong, I think. It could be 18, could be 19-3, I don't know what. Can't read my own writing there. Nick Lentz has a better record, 22-5. His past record is not so brilliant. Win, no contest, loss, win. But one of those losses I seem to recall was pretty close. Or maybe that was the no contest, I can't remember. He's actually quite exciting, I do like him. I think that he stands a chance of winning here, because I have a feeling that Diego Nunes is beginning to go downhill a bit. So I'm going to go for a Nick Lentz decision on this. Edson Barboza is fighting Lucas Martins. Edson Barboza, 10-1. Lucas is a perfect record of 12. This is going to be one fought on their feet. And I think I'm going to give the experience and the higher calibre of people fought to Edson Barboza. And I'm going to go for a TKO in the second there. And then there's the main event, which is Vitor Belfort versus Michael Bisping. And what we have to remember about this is that Vitor Belfort only loses to the highest calibre. When I'm talking about the highest calibre, I'm talking about John Jones, Anderson Silva, Dan Henderson, Randy Couture, all people who are basically, you know, champions in some way, shape or form. Certainly, you know, people have said that Michael Bisping's improved, he's got better and better. Yes, and, you know, he may well try the picking apart game But I think I see this one going pretty much the same as the Dan Henderson match in the end. So I'm going to say that I think Vitor Belfort will win this by TKO in the second. The only, you know, Michael Bisping does have a slightly better record, that is true. And he is younger, I think, so, you know, he may have that on his side. But it's the point that if he does manage to beat Vitor, he'll be, you know, one of the only people in Vitor's entire record who has managed to beat him without first being a champion who has managed to have an extensive reign. And that goes all the way back. anyway, so I'm going to stick with Vitor Belfort there. Now, the rest of the card, we've got Francisco Trinaldo versus CJ Keith, Ronnie Marks versus Andrew Craig, Godofredo Castro versus Milton Vieira, and Daniel Sarafian versus CB Dolloway. And you can see at the end of the video my predictions for that. MMA Playground is also advertising two extra bouts on the card. Don't know if they're happening or not. But I've given predictions for them anyway at the end of the card. We've got Pedro Nobre versus Yuri Alcantara, and Wagner Prado versus Idemar Alcantara. So that is it for my UFC on FX7 predictions video.